Oh my god, my legs fell off. It's alright. It's alright. We know exactly where that is. It's just around the corner. What are you talking about? I didn't save. I'm right here. Right here at my spawn point. My body is right over here. See? There I am. That's the whole point to why I decided to fight here. Wow. Nasty. There we go. And now I have all my stuff back. Repair. Okay. Hooray. We'll just drop these broken axes. Alright. Good. Now, see, I'm wondering if that guy's still injured. Or not. I mean, either way. I bet if you kill one, you get a lot of shit. That's, worth investigating. Never managed to kill one of those guys yet. I see I'm almost leveled up again. I just got a little bit more to go. So I guess we gotta make a new bedroll every time we want to do that, eh? Okay. So we'll do that just to make sure we don't lose our spawn point, because I think that's probably what happened last time. Thank you. Alright, so now we are safe. I think I just raid the area close to the spot. Oh, look, more eggs. Awesome. One positive thing about dying is I'm not starving anymore. Came back to life very well fed. Okay. We're going to try to kill this thing. Yes, he's injured. Be fucking back up, please. Never mind. Oh. Oh. Wow. He hit me so hard I split into two people. Amazing. That was pretty fucking funny, I gotta say. I gotta wait for him to walk away from my corpse. But hey, I killed the elk. Or Where am I? Here I am. Which one is the real me? There's literally two of me here. I better harvest both of me, just to be on the safe side. Oh, savory flesh and putrid meat. Sweet. That is fantastic. I really want that thing dead now. He's killed me. He's killed me twice. In a way that resulted in three corpses. There's literally two of me. And then there's the me that's over here. I'm just gonna keep grabbing rocks, and if he attacks me again, we'll fight him again. And then I'll raid my 5th, 6th, and 7th corpses from one death. Yep. So, resources respawn too. So this is actually a really good area because it's near water, of course. There's creatures around, so you can kill things for food. And then there's, sticks and rocks, which are basically two of your main building materials. And, trees, of course, too. Oh, yeah, Stout is saying, bedroll. Yeah, good idea. Probably do that bedroll thing. I need twine. Yes, we will make two bedrolls. So we'll already have one ready for when we die. Inevitably. Here we are. Extra sure we've got our spawn points. Okay, now that guy must be almost dead by now. Seriously, let's go take him down. I'm tired of his bullshit. Looting the corpse when I'm not respawned yet. I honestly don't know. Not entirely sure how that worked exactly. No, okay. You can just fuck off. Seriously, just walk away so I can go and raid my damn corpse. Is this it here? Yeah. Alright. Good. Oh, he's got blood on him from our fight. That's great. That seemed to take 3 hits. Awesome. And I leveled up. So is this giving me hide as well? How am I not getting hide from this? Like, what exactly do I need? I don't know. Well, I don't know. How are we doing for rocks? 141. See, it'd be nice when I can just have my little house and actually put a bed in it. So something that I don't have to keep remaking every time. Just have a permanent bed. You're carrying too much and cannot move. Well, we should probably level up our encumbrance then, shouldn't we? Yes, let's get one of those. Oh, I can move again. Excellent. And then, yeah, everything else I seem to be... You know, I'm going to bump this up because I'm doing a lot of melee combat, so... Melee, whatever. Whatever! Sandstone. Like, why can't I build things out of wood? Oh, a pillar. Handler, armorer, pillar. Okay, so I have 2 available. What is this? Oh, ambrosia offering to Mitra. Doesn't require anything. Oh, I guess because I'm already an acolyte or whatever. Stone dagger. Oh, that would probably be handy, and I'm sure will help us unlock other bladed weapons. So, all right, cool. Well, let's carry on working on the old homestead here. Should have a spare bedroll on hand. Oh, Stout's just hitting the corpse to get a hide. Well, let's, or maybe now... Actually, hold on. Can I make a knife? I just need some twine. Yeah, I can do that. I need 10 twine? Seriously? Oh my god. Alright, we need more plant fiber. Alright. I figure if I can make a dagger, maybe I can use that to skin it. If it's still there. It's probably not there anymore. Yeah, it was like right here. It's gone. Bark. grab some eggs. Gotta have some breakfast in the morning, you know. Alright, can we make this? Yes. Yes, we can. Alright. So let's, well, actually, let's just get that going. And then we'll head on over to... Is it here? Yeah. Alright, and then we'll, I don't know, put it right here, I guess. Sure. Wow, how come theirs is so much bigger? What? Where'd my savory meat go? Holy crap. What is with all this crafting? Current fuel. What? No, hold on. There. Yeah, take all. No. Oh, there we go. Okay. It rotted. Okay. Well, let's cook the putrid meat. Not cook. Whatever this used to be, it is inedible now. Well, fuck you. Or maybe I could cook some flavor back. Let's cook the eggs. Can we cook the eggs? Oh, wait a second. 'Thralled. Oh, see, this is interesting. Can I cook the grubs? Can I throw it in here? Okay, hold on a second. So we get fuel. We put food. Turn it on. And it makes cooked meat. Okay. Alright, well. I guess the rest we just eat raw. Well, I want to cook some grubs. Well. Yes, we will make two foundations. Perfect. We have the base of our house. Check it out. So definitely not like Minecraft where fires just burn forever. Alright. We have our spawn point. That. Oh. It's out now. There was a fire up there I saw up in the mountains. Yeah, it's fine if he's walking around up there. Look at this. We have the makings of a fucking house. Awesome. Let's go get... Oh, I should probably turn the fire off. Hold on. I like how the campfire just has an on-off switch. There we go. Just like in real life. Okay. Very nice. I gotta say, this is a fantastic spot to be building a place, I think. Like, this is actually way better than the previous spot by a pretty big stretch, so I'm pretty happy that we stumbled across this completely by chance. We got lots of resources that respawn nearby, and very handy. Yeah, I think this will be a good place to set up shop for a while. Oh, okay, those guys are way over there. They're across the water. They're not going to do anything to me over here. Oh, ginormous statues. Awesome. I get, like, Jason and the Argonauts vibes from that. Let's see what's on this little island here. Yeah, that's possible. I was thinking of that. Strumdog says maybe use the putrid meat as bait. Yes. That is a good idea. See, I gotta get out of the Minecraft mindset, where, like, things just don't spoil. You can have 100 cooked steaks, or raw steaks, in your pocket for days, and they'll be just as good as the day you killed that cow. And same with pork. Pork? Going bad? Nonsense! What do you think this is? Real life? So... Oh! What? Where? Oh, fuck me! No. No fucking way. Creature that can go in water. Okay, if it's following me, then... Shit, it is, too. Well... Wow. Yeah, I didn't expect to survive that. You asshole. Wow. It is a crocodile. Okay. I guessed it right the first time. Thank God for bedrolls. Huh? That was the most pathetic jump ever. Okay, did the crocodile go away? Yes, he went away. Alright. Can we just... Yes, thank you. Alright. Good. I wonder if I dropped the rancid meat if he would go for that. Here, eat this lump of green steak instead of meat. Trust me, it's just as good, if not better. Oh god, Stoud made a clip. I'll share it on my page. on my Twitch page when we're done here. Stoud likes it when I flee in terror from things. It brings him joy. Seeing me terrified beyond belief. That's twice now. I wasn't killed by the crocodile last time. I just got scared and ran away. But, I don't know. I thought I'm getting a little brazen, I think, with my big hammer. I figured, well, hey, I got a big hammer. What's gonna hurt me? Well, so far, everything. The only thing I've managed to kill with my ginormous hammer is docile creatures that are too dumb to run away or fight back. And that's just the way I like it. See, getting more rocks because we want to start building the other parts of our house. I want it to start looking, you know, like an actual house. Or at least a decent hut. Okay, where is it? See, is it? Obviously I picked a good spot, because I keep forgetting where it is. There it is. Tucked away in the corner. Alright, so let's see, what do we need here? So, obviously we need walls. Well, probably make a door frame here. Put that in the front. What does it take to make a door? Need more twine. Yeah, let's go make a bunch of twine. Need 10 twine? Seriously? Alright, need more plants and shit. I mean, at least I'm getting down the... I'm definitely getting the building process down here. Sort of figuring out what we can build. I basically just want a nice, safe shelter that I can hole up in at night, you know? Or when I'm between game sessions. Sure, just grab whatever's there. Came over here for veggies, but you can, you know, grab other stuff too. Okay, grab some eggs. You know, we're gonna grab a drink of water while we're here, too. Yep. Shelter! What? They keep saying that. It's like, that's under the water. You dumbass suggestion box. Okay. Door frame. Boom! Right there. Look at that. The makings of a home, ladies and gentlemen. I'm even gonna put a door on it. Perfect. All right, now. Yes, let us make three walls. That's excellent. Thanks. We'll do 1, 2, 3, because we kind of got protection from the cliff here, so that's good. There we go. Uh-huh. Yeah! Look at that! Fuck yeah! Alright, this isn't all that secure, but hey! It's coming along nicely. It's actually starting to look like something now. Look at that. Okay, I'm a long way from that cross in the desert. Alright, what do we need for a roof? Basically, more rocks and more wood. I need to make more axes. That's what I need. And... okay. Good. Alright. Excellent. Let's see how the door works. It works exactly the way I expected it to. There are more options for the door. You can dismantle it. Oh, you can dismantle things. Let's interact with the door. Or you can just press E. I'm so happy. I have a door now. Look at that. A perfectly functioning door. Look at the door from this side. Oh, see, it opens both ways. Now that is a quality door, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. That is fantastic. All right. Do we have enough to make a bedroll here? There we go. I'm so happy. Things have actually gone fairly well tonight. Throw that in there. Make sure we've got our... I'm not taking any chances with the spawn points anymore, so... that is good. That is wonderful. So, I am working early mornings, so I should probably be heading to bed. It's almost midnight here, and I gotta be up at like 6 in the morning, so... yeah, I can get by in 6. 6 hours is fine. Any less than 6 hours, I start to be a bit of a zombie, but... yeah. Strumdog says you probably shouldn't be wearing those hinges out. Yeah. I think it's fine. The only thing is, you know, if anybody attacks my house or damages it, then you gotta repair it. There's like an actual, there's a repair hammer that you can make. And, you use that to repair, structures, basically. So, they got it all covered, man. They got it all covered. All right. So I think we're going to call it a night here, folks. But yeah, I'm very happy with how things went tonight. You know, actually got some shit done, figured some shit out, and, you know, it actually turned out to be good that we got lost in the desert and went in completely the wrong direction. Like, I'm feeling way better about this location than our previous one on the island surrounded by death. Yeah, this is a way better location, and I'm determined to kill that shaleback that's killed me like 4 times. Well, technically 3, but somehow resulting in 4 corpses. Anyway, have yourselves a wonderful night, and thanks for joining me. So until next time, sayonara.